Infection with human papillomavirus is considered the most common sexually transmitted disease. It is known that HPV is associated with development of cervical cancer. However, it is a necessary but not sufficient condition for development of cervical cancer. The main aim of the population screening program is to detect precancerous lesions in order to early treatment. For this reason, when a high-grade lesion is found, the standard treatment is surgery by conization. Adolescents are particularly at risk of infection because of the special characteristics of their cervical epithelium and their sexual practices that may leave up to 70% of them infected with HPV. However, most of these infections are transient, lasting only a few months. Because of that, the recommended approach to low-grade cytological lesion in this group of patients is observation without treatment. The problem arises when a high-grade lesion is found in a young woman. Should we do a conization? On the one hand, conization is an invasive procedure that can have adverse reproductive outcomes and increase the risk of preterm delivery. On the other hand, some authors have described high rates of regression of precancerous lesion in young women. A change in the management of high-grade lesion in young women in favor of conservative treatment is happening. This is a prospective observational study. The main aim is to describe the outcome in high-grade cytology paps and not histologically confirmed of cervical intraepithelial neoplasia, CIN grade 3, in young women. The secondary goal is to demonstrate the efficacy of conservative management in preventing progression to invasive carcinoma. We included patients aged under 25 years or younger with diagnosis at the screening program of high-grade intraepithelial lesion in the cervical cytology. Pregnant women or with any type of immunosuppression were excluded. We performed to all the patients a colposcopy with cervical biopsy, then endocervical curettage. If the result of biopsy was low-grade lesion or less, the same procedure was performed every 6 months for 2 years. However, if the result was CIN grade 2, the same procedure was performed in the first 3 and 6 months of diagnosis and then every 6 months for 2 years. If in some of the visits we obtain an insatisfactory colposcopy or biopsy with a result of CIN grade 3, or a positive endocervical curettage, excisional treatment was carried out. In all cases, an HPV test was performed every 12 months. A total of 29 patients were included. The follow-up was 15 months. Even if all patients included in the study had a high-grade cytological lesion at the screening program, that was confirmed by biopsy only in 52% of them. We noticed that there was a higher percentage of multiple HPV serotypes in the high-grade histological lesion, 40% versus 30%, reaching a statistical significance. During the follow-up, 63% of high-grade cytological lesions were cleared. The most important observation was that all CIN grade 2 histological lesions disappeared at 9 months of follow-up without any medical or surgical treatment. American consensus in 2006 for the treatment of young women with CIN grade 3 suggest a follow-up colposcopy and cytology every 6 months. This indicates that colposcopy is an alternative to conization in this group of patients. A decrease in the number of conization leads to a fall of adverse perinatal effects. Our results suggest that conservative management of young women with high-grade cytological result is a good therapeutic option. based on the latest knowledge of the natural history of HPV infection.